These are some hidden actions you can't get in the stock Shortcuts app. Using some third-party apps, you can get things like device storage, play custom sounds in your Shortcuts, pull the hex code of colors from an image. And there's some great actions to use in automations and if statements. But I went through all the actions those two apps offer you, and I'm going to show you some real-world Shortcuts to use those actions right now. So these are the two apps, Toolbox Pro and Actions. There are some paid features. I'll put that information in the description as well. But let's jump into Shortcuts and start using some of these custom actions. I'll create a new shortcut, and these I will put links down in the video description so you can download them on your own. And the first one let's try is Get Device Storage. It's a number of taps getting your device storage, going to Settings, General, iPhone Storage, and sometimes it'll take a second to load. And here you can get the total capacity, remaining space, or use space for your device, and just running this action will immediately show you your available space right there. So that's much faster than diving into the settings, especially if you put this shortcut somewhere like the Today view. This is where I keep a lot of the shortcuts that I run quickly, but you can also use that in something like an automation. So for instance, maybe we want something to run every morning. I'll create an automation for time of day. Let's just run it at sunrise. This is gonna run daily, and we want it to run immediately, no notification when run. We'll do a new blank automation. We'll do Get Device Storage, and we want the remaining space in gigabytes. Now for our next action, let's search for number, and we're gonna choose this number action here. We wanna pull the number from the device storage. If we run that real quick, we should see that it pulls the number, and that's the available or remaining space. Now we're gonna add an if statement. So if the number, and we added that number action, this way we get options like is greater than or is less than. And now we can do is less than and choose what number you want to be notified by. Let's say your iPhone goes below 25 available gigabytes. You can choose to have it send a notification. Here, show notification is a built-in action for shortcuts. And we could say show notification. If we expand that notification action, we can choose to play a sound or not. But for the text, let's actually choose the device storage result, and that'll give us the gigabytes still available. I'm gonna move this to the otherwise just because I wanna see it run and I have more than 25 available. But if we play this, then you'll see you'll get a notification with your available space. So this automation can run every morning, and then when your storage space falls below 25 available gigabytes, you'll get that notification and you can start deleting stuff if you need. All right, let's create a new shortcut. And this is one of the actions available in Toolbox Pro, which is Get Sound. A lot of times if you wanted a sound to play, maybe to confirm that a shortcut has run properly, there's not a lot of options unless you want Siri to speak to you. But here you can choose to get a specific system sound. Scrolling here, you can find all these different sounds, even something like a tweet sent sound. Then put this somewhere in your shortcut and add the action Play Sound. I'll search for that here. And now when we run this shortcut, it's gonna play that sound we chose. And again, you can change this to something else, like the lock. And you can add these two steps in your automation or shortcut of choice. This way you can hear an audible sound to confirm that that shortcut has run. For number three, we're actually gonna pull colors from an image and get the hex codes usable for graphic design or web development. We're gonna search for Get Colors. And this action is actually from the third-party app Actions. You see the little app icon there. We're gonna choose Get Dominant Colors from Image. You can choose how many colors you want to pull from an image, and it's waiting for the input. For this kind of shortcut, I actually want it to appear in the share sheet, like when I'm looking at photos in my library. So I'm going to toggle on the Show in Share Sheet, then hit Done. You access that with the little eye icon at the bottom. Then for Receiving, I'm going to turn everything off except for Images and Media. I'll also choose Files, because maybe I have an image in my Files app that I want to share. Then I'm going to tap and hold this blank space. I can select a variable, and I wanted to get it from the shortcut input. Then I'll add a quick look action at the end so I can see those dominant colors from an image. And let's name the shortcut something descriptive like Get Colors from Image, and we'll hit Done. Now let's go over to our Photos app. Here I have the artwork for Primary Technology, my tech podcast with Jason Aten. You should definitely listen. Links are down below. I'm gonna hit the Share button, then go down, and you'll see the shortcut we just created, Get Colors from Image. If I run the shortcut, it's gonna analyze the dominant colors of the image and then give me those five colors. I specified five in the action, and here it is. I know you have white, and then other colors dominant to this image. A great way to pull those hex color codes from an image anywhere that you can share that image with the share button. Number four, not only can you recognize colors in an image, but you can actually recognize objects in an image. If I search for objects, this is a Toolbox Pro action. I'll add that to the shortcut. Let's do the same thing, hitting the I button at the bottom, show this in the share sheet so it can appear everywhere. And to recognize objects in whatever we share, we'll tap and hold, select variable to the shortcut input. Let's add that quick look action so we can see it wherever we are. And let's label this shortcut. We'll call it Identify Objects. We'll hit Done. Now let's go to a photo with an object in it. Here's a picture of an iPad mini. Hopefully that gets update in the Apple event soon as I record. We'll hit the share button and then scroll down. There's our identify object shortcut we just renamed. And if I run that shortcut, it's gonna show us what it thinks is there. And you'll see it's 48% sure that that's an iPad in the photo. Now this is a great couple actions where you can also use with some if statements or automations. Maybe you run this when you take some pictures, and if it contains people, then you could put it into a photo album and things like that. Number 5, you might want to manually crop an image within a shortcut. There is a built-in crop function in shortcuts that you get just with the app, but if you take a look at that action, it's really just for specifying a resolution and then cropping it in a specific direction. You can do a custom and try to do X and Y coordinates, but sometimes you just want to crop it with the standard cropping tools. Well, you can do that with a Toolbox Pro action. I'm gonna do a select photos action first. You wanna include all kinds of photos. You can choose to select multiple if you want. Then I'm actually gonna add a convert image action, only because I take live photos and the live photos will show up as videos in this next action, and I don't want that. So I'm gonna convert the photo that I choose to a JPEG, keep full quality, but I'm gonna take off the preserve metadata, maybe because this is a photo I'm gonna share. Now if we search for crop, you'll see Toolbox Pro has an action called crop image manually. If we use that action, expanding that, you do wanna keep this checked on, basically because this is gonna send you over to the Toolbox Pro app in order to crop the image, copy it to the clipboard, and then bring you back to this shortcut. So you wanna keep that enabled. Now we have to add two actions, and this is gonna be a practice for a couple of the shortcuts we build in a second as well. Search for this wait to return action. That means the shortcut is just gonna hold on until we come back to it from the Toolbox Pro app, and that's gonna happen automatically. So we're gonna wait to return. Now we're gonna add a get clipboard. Because Toolbox Pro has to find a way to get the cropped image back, it's gonna copy it to your clipboard. So we're gonna do the get clipboard action, and then from here you can choose to save it to your photos, do a quick look, or share that image, but I'm just gonna add a quick look so we can quickly see it. This will be one of the shortcuts I link down in the video description if you just wanna download it. Keep in mind you do need the Toolbox Pro app installed on your phone. If I run this shortcut, you see it's gonna get my photos. I can choose one of the photos from my library. I'm gonna choose this book here. And now I got sent over to the Toolbox Pro app, ready to crop it. And here I can access the different cropping resolutions. Maybe I wanna go 16:9. I'll crop this photo, maybe zoom in a little bit. Then when I hit done, it's gonna send me back to the shortcut, and I'll preview the image, and you see here it is cropped 16:9, and then I can do whatever I'd like. Hit the share button again, save it to photos, maybe I wanna annotate it, but this is a great way to manually crop images within a shortcut, and you get those typical cropping tools that you're used to. All right, next are a couple actions that I've actually shared in past videos, but I'm gonna remind you here, and then I'll link you to those automations, but there's two audio-based actions in Toolbox Pro. One is get audio output device. This is really useful, especially if you want to run automations based on whether or not you have AirPods in. So if you were to start with that action, I'm going to add a text action here because it just makes the if statement a little easier. So get details of the current audio output device, change that to a text, and now I'm going to add an if statement. I'm actually going to put a link to this shortcut as well, and you can use this in an automation just by creating the automation I'm going to specify and choosing the run shortcut action. I'll show you that in a second. So if text, and we'll put contains, and let's make this AirPods, then do nothing. So if I have my AirPods connected to my iPhone, I don't want the automation to do anything. Otherwise, let's search for volume, and here we're gonna choose the set volume action. We're gonna put that in the otherwise column, and we're gonna change that percentage to 0. And what I'm gonna do is put this for an automation of when I open Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, and if I have AirPods connected and I'm listening, this doesn't do anything. But if I don't have AirPods connected, which is the otherwise, it's gonna mute my iPhone. So there's no audio playing out loud, could be embarrassing in a waiting room or something like that. I'm gonna label this shortcut, are AirPods connected? And how you would use this as an automation, I'll go to that tab, hit the plus button, let's go down to app as the trigger, and we can choose when an app is open. And here you can actually choose multiple apps. So maybe we'll do Instagram and YouTube, and then we'll hit done. I want this to run immediately. Don't notify me when run. We'll go to next. Go to new blank automation. Now we're gonna search for the run shortcut action. Now let's search for our AirPods connected shortcut. I'm gonna expand this little shortcut menu. I don't have to do anything with the input, and then we'll hit done. Then what this automation will do, either when I open Instagram or YouTube, it's gonna check, do I have AirPods connected to my phone? And if I do, it'll leave the volume the same, but if I don't, meaning it'll come out of my iPhone speakers, it's gonna turn that volume down to 0. That's the get audio output device action. Now, number 7, I have another automation where I use the action is audio playing. So in this shortcut, I use the Toolbox Pro action is audio playing, and I showed how to build this in a previous shortcuts video. I'll link it above and down in the description. But this means if I'm listening to a podcast and I open Instagram or YouTube, meaning there's already audio currently playing, I don't want it to change my volume because I don't want my podcast to stop playing, even if a video might start autoplaying in the background. Otherwise, if I don't have audio playing, meaning there's no podcast, no music, then mute my device. So when I open Instagram and TikTok, it'll bring that volume down to zero. Again, I explain the shortcut more in detail down in the video description, but I love this because you're not interrupted if you're listening to a podcast, but if nothing's playing, then you won't have those videos playing loudly from social apps when you open them. All right, number eight, if you wanna do advanced if statements, but the current date thing is kind of messing you up, it messed me up for a while, there's actually an action from Toolbox Pro called Format Date Extended. When you choose that action, you can get the current date. So I'm gonna choose current date down here from the little swipey toolbar. And then you can choose how you want that to display. So you can display it as day, like the day of the week. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. But if you tap day, this action can format the current date in all these different styles. Makes it much easier to use this in if statements. So maybe you want something to just be Monday through Friday, like a work day. Well, you can do that. And you see the result if I run this shortcut, it'll tell you Monday because that's today. It's much easier to use this forming than I find the built-in date formatting options. I have lots of shortcuts coming that are gonna be using this kind of date formatting, so subscribe to the channel, stay tuned, coming soon. Another great action to use in your shortcuts is remove duplicates. Here, if I search for remove duplicates, the Actions third-party app has an option for that as well, so does Toolbox Pro. But this is great to use if maybe you have a long list of URLs, maybe you're formatting show notes for a podcast. And if we hit the I, we can actually put this in the share sheet as well. Maybe we just wanna remove duplicates from a spreadsheet list or something else. So let's show in share sheet, and let's label this, we'll do remove duplicates. I don't want this to show everywhere, so I'm gonna clear all the different things, and I just want this to look at URLs and text and rich text. Now let's also add a split text command after these shortcuts because it needs to be able to see the list. So we're gonna split it by new lines. Then we want to remove duplicates from the split text. And then we're going to add a combine text option after that Toolbox Pro action. So combine the deduplicated list with new lines. And then you probably wanna add a copy to clipboard action or something else after that, but we're just gonna show it in the quick look. Now that we have that set up, I'll go to a plain text list here. Remember, this could be URLs or anything else where you might have duplicates. I'm gonna select this list. And because we have this showing in the share sheet, I can go over in this little contextual menu, hit the share button, we'll run our remove duplicates shortcut. And there we have the same list with duplicates removed. So now decoder is only once, primary technology is only once. Again, a great way if you have a bunch of URLs or maybe you have a big spreadsheet and you wanna remove any duplicates, this is a great action to use. It can be in the share sheet or you can choose to do things like get clipboard or start the shortcut with other triggers. Number 10, Toolbox Pro has a scan NFC tag action where you can read an NFC tag. You need to use the wait to return action, like I mentioned before, get the clipboard like our crop image shortcut, and then you can show the result in that quick look. This is an interesting way to scan an NFC tag before you actually scan it to go to a website and see where it's actually sending you. So I actually have my Wi-Fi porter here. This is a cool little device where someone can either scan a QR code or an NFC tag and connect to your Wi-Fi. So I'm actually going to run this shortcut. You see, you go over to the Toolbox Pro app and it's ready to scan an NFC tag. I can hold it close and you see it scanned that URL. And this is gonna show me a preview of what URL this NFC tag is sending me to. I'm blurring some of it out because it's a custom URL to connect to my personal home Wi-Fi, but you could see what's behind that NFC tag before you actually scan or load it in Safari. Number 11, the Actions third-party app has some very cool actions, one of them being changing the case or title case of a word. Here I'm gonna search and you can get the transform text action. Again, this is the third-party app called Actions. We're gonna transform and I'm gonna have it ask each time. This way I can just type in a word and it's gonna transform it using a bunch of different options. This is a really useful action to put in share sheet actions if you wanna do things like strip punctuation, strip quotation marks, even strip HTML if you wanna do that from the text that you input. Here I'm gonna choose just Pascal case and this will put words together and then capitalize each word within that. I'm gonna choose the quick look action just so we can see it. And if we run this, now I can type some text. I'll type something like primary text show. You can see the second two words are lowercase and there's spaces between it. But if I hit done, it's gonna transform that text and there is the Pascal case, meaning there's no spaces, all the words together, but it capitalized each word individually. Again, a great action for stripping quotation marks, HTML, really flexible action. Number 12, there's a great Git Unsplash image action. You can actually do this with the built-in Unsplash app as well, but Actions has this, and I like the options it offers here. And then you can also customize keywords and do only featured images, and even choose what kind of size image you want, either a specific screen size or even custom. I'll do any only featured images, and this is a great way where you can ask for input first. You can see that's its own individual action here. I'll put it at the top of the shortcut. So we're gonna ask for text with, and that's just a custom prompt we'll see. And then for the keywords, I could tap in there and we'll choose the provided input, basically what we type in the first action. Then you could do cool things like set wallpaper. So if you wanna change the wallpaper of your device automatically, you can hard code those keywords or even choose from a random list, have that run every morning, and you can choose to have a different wallpaper and wake up to it every day. I'll just add a quick look so we could see the image. And then when I run this shortcut, it'll ask me to search for something. Let's say waterfall, hit done, and it'll get a random royalty-free Unsplash image. That would probably look great as a wallpaper actually. Then I can either hit the share button, save this, set it as a wallpaper, or even hard code those actions. Maybe you want to save every image that you pull to a specific album. You could search for the photos action, and you can choose save that to an album called wallpapers, set it as your wallpaper every morning, use this in an automation, really flexible. Love this from the third-party actions app, Git Unsplash Image. Link to download this shortcut down in the video description as well. All right, and number 13, our last shortcut for today, this is going to be Git related words. Think of this as a built-in thesaurus. You can choose the language and the minimum amount of related words you would like. And to make this really useful, we're gonna tap the eye one more time, add this to the share sheet, hit done. We're gonna clear all the results and only have it pull from text and rich text, hit done. Let's call this shortcut the power thesaurus. Now when I'm looking at text, maybe I'm writing, I can tap on a word, maybe I'll select the word talk. Let me go over and while the lookup command will give you some results, I'm gonna use my power thesaurus and look at all these synonyms for talk. And again, you can increase this number to 100, 200, whatever you would like, and get a bunch of related words using that action. And those are some secret shortcuts actions. Again, links to those third-party apps is down in the description. I would love to hear what you build with these. Maybe it's automations or productivity shortcuts. Let me know down in the comments. And I have a bunch of requests from you. I'll be doing a shortcuts request video, basically building shortcuts that you've asked for in the comments very soon, maybe this weekend. Don't hold me to it, but it's gonna come very soon. So subscribe to the channel, hit that bell icon so you don't miss it. And you know, you never know, you might have missed a shortcuts video. I'll put that entire playlist of my shortcuts right here. You could just binge watch that, that's great. Or if you'd like to learn about maybe some Mac apps that I use for my process, like making videos and podcasts, you could check out this video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.